As we're in the Soul Alchemist, it's time for Pick Your Own Card weekly guidance for the 12th through to the 18th of December. So if you've not had a chance to pick a card, I want you to tune into cards 1, 2, or 3 and listen to the messages, the themes, and the energies that I'm going to be revealing to you. Now, what I would say is that all three messages are probably going to relate and resonate in some shape or form. So try and listen to all three. It won't take very long, and just take on those messages. Also, there's a bonus card, which for this week is about money and wealth, and I'm going to reveal that at the end. So if you've picked card 1, it is the Queen of Keys, and just want to mention I've got a new backdrop, so we're now in the Akashic Records, just to let you know. Okay, so the Queen of Keys. So what you can see, if you've got this queen, that she's on the top of her castle and she's looking over her estate and she's feeling very accomplished, feeling very successful. So this week we've got an opportunity to look at our successes this year, also look at perhaps from 2022, also maybe look at the things that didn't quite work out, and also reflect on what the success was in there, what the silver lining, what the gold is, because we don't want to really kind of look at our failures or the things that didn't quite pan out as failures. You know what I mean? There's always going to be something in there that is going to support you. So we've got an opportunity this week to reflect on 2022 and understand what are the things that we can take into 2023. We've also got an opportunity to work with money, the energy of money, in a deeper way. So looking at ways for you to be able to have money work for you. So that could be more investments. It could be looking at how you can swap and save. We don't always have to be physically creating within, you know, a job or within our business in order to feel successful or to have the energy of money supporting us. So I want you to also reflect on how you can be more mindful with your money, or do more money management to also to have that sense of feeling successful with money. I also think that there was going to be some ideas and downloads that will come to you this week that's also going to support you with taking, especially if you're in business or maybe wanting to up-level yourself within your career, there's going to be ways for you to offer something to maybe to your workplace or to your business where the, you know, you can create a bigger income flow. So there might be new ideas for programs or services there. Or as I say, if you're in a workplace, it might be an idea, wanting to take on more responsibility, which, you know, gives you that kind of it kind of puts you in front of your managers or your peers as somebody that can actually step up and do more. And but obviously that's kind of paves the way for you to have a career advancement and things like that. So the Queen of Keys, dealing with money, feeling accomplished, feeling successful, looking at 2022, but also what can you take into 2023 and how can you get money to work for you this week? So that's all the messages that are linked with card one. There's quite a few in there. If you want to go deeper with money, with business, with your 2023 just in general, then I have got something special that I downloaded downloaded last night. That's why I couldn't sleep. Not last night, the night before. And it's going to be a 2023 forecast, and that's going to be on a special price. So if that's something that you feel that you would like, 12 cards. It's going to be a voice recording. You're going to get the image of the cards. There's going to be a little bit of an Akashic healing in there, and also a energetic coding, recoding for you to take into 2023. Then DM me and I'll tell you more about that. Okay, so moving on to card 2. Very different energy. This is about you taking stock. It's about slowing down. It's about taking your energy inwards and not being all things to all people external to you. So if you're feeling a little bit scattered, a little bit kind of everywhere recently, and it might not be because you're supporting loads of people, it's just that you've just not had a chance to slow down and just take this time to go inwards and see what your needs are. And how are you fulfilling your needs? And if not, what steps can you do to do that? So this week, this card is saying, or the Akashic Records are saying, it is time to slow down and reflect on what needs, what your needs are. Your needs might have changed over 2022. They might have changed even from last week, because we're ever evolving and growing. So our needs are going to differ. They're going to realign. They're going to change. But have you done that kind of self-reflection to find out what that is? And if you haven't, then this card is saying, go inwards, take a little bit of pause this week. It doesn't have to be very long, but just ask yourself, are my needs being met? And if not, what are my needs, first of all? What are the essential things that allow me to feel fulfilled or feel healthy or feel like I can just get out of bed every day and just, you know, not just get through life, but live life? There's a real big difference there. And are your needs being met? And that doesn't necessarily need to be met by other people, but sometimes it will be, because we need to have those conversations. And maybe those conversations haven't been had yet, and we are holding on to the resentment that your needs are not being met. But if they've not been communicated, then the other person may not be aware of that. So this is about really going inwards, taking that pause, but really reflecting on what your needs are and how you can get them met more appropriately. And that's going to really support you for 2023 as well. So do take that time this week. This is for you, taking time for you, so that when your needs are met, then you fulfill the needs of others in a much more effective and efficient way that is better from a time, energy perspective. So the Buddha prepares. Let me know how that card resonates. And also, as I say, if you want to jump on board my 2023 forecast, 12 cards, it is going to include a little bit of Akashic record healing and also some Akashic soul recoding, energetic recoding. It's going to be a voice recorded session that will get sent to you with the picture of the cards. Let me know. It is on a very special price. There's not going to be many spaces for it. I was guided to create this. It came in a download, not last night, the night before. So DM me if you want any more information around that. Okay, so the final card, card three, and as I say, all three of these messages will resonate, so please do go back and listen. It is the views of the ego. So you can see we've got this guy looking at his reflection. He can't see any other people because it's all about him. So ego is going to be big this week. Now, this could be your ego. It could be somebody else's ego. Egos are going to be having tantrums. They're going to make themselves known. And so the gift in this card this week is for you to see that and see what is truly going on. Be very neutral about that, choosing to respond and not react, choosing to observe and not absorb. And just be mindful that you can see what is truly going on for that person. So, you know, for instance, our ego can come forward when we feel triggered and we're reacting because we feel hurt, or we're feeling kind of we're feeling pushed in some kind of way. And so we have that, the ego is coming forward. And so the beauty in this card is that we are able to see that. We can be neutral. We can understand. We can see what's really going on underneath. And then that allows us the space and the time to be able to respond appropriately and not then go into a kind of emotional kind of tit for tat where each person is getting wounded or hurt or whatever it might be. We're just reflecting back on each other. You get a chance to do that pattern interrupt and not do that. So that is the beauty of this card, is seeing the ego this week. And this might be your own ego also stepping up if you're going through a period of transition or growth or up level. And, you know, when you're pushing your own, you know, you're putting yourself in your growth zone, getting out your comfort zone, then the ego is going to be a little bit more chatty. There's going to be some negative narratives that come up there, self-sabotage. And again, the beauty of this card is to see what is truly going on and celebrate the ego for stepping in and letting itself be known, because you know then it's like, oh, okay, I'm going through a period of change here. And obviously my ego doesn't like that. It's trying to keep me safe. It's holding me back. It's all perfect. So again, you get to choose to respond and not react. And, you know, normally we react in an emotional way and we get sucked into whatever the negative narrative or the emotionality of what we're feeling, and then we don't progress forward. So the views of the ego, egoic tantrums happening somewhere in your experience this week, in your life, choose to react and not respond, observe and not absorb. So let me know how that card resonates for you. And as I say, if you want details on my 2023 forecast with 12 cards, it's like an Akashic soul alignment type forecast, then let me know. It includes Akashic record healing, and also it also includes a specific energetic coding that will also support your alignment in 2023. Reach out if you want more info for that. So if you are waiting, hopefully you are, for the money and wealth bonus card, it's actually a repeater from last week. It's the Queen of Roses. So money and wealth has a direct connection to deservability, self-worth, and how we're taking care of our own needs. Also, how we take care of money and the energetics of money. So if we are nurturing money and nourishing money, and that's a reflection of ourselves as well, then, you know, money's going to hang around. Money wants to be in our life, you know, when we're coming from that perspective. But if we are ignoring money, or if we are feeling ashamed of money, if we complain about money, if we're not looking at our numbers or kind of looking at how we can work with money in a more effective way, then again, money's not going to really show up for us. Money won't want to stay in our experience. And, you know, we have a lot of emotions attached to money. It brings up lots of stories. It brings up lots of conditioning. Money is the greatest healer, one of the greatest healers that we have in our experience, that's tangible. It's also not tangible, because, you know, Apple Pay, all of that type of stuff. But money is a energetic, it's an object that can heal so much. It can also highlight all of our flaws, all of our beliefs, all of our wounds, all of our trauma, all of our stories, all of our illusions. And, you know, people say money makes the world go round. My gosh, we have placed a lot of responsibility and value on money. And so this week we've got an opportunity to connect with it in a deeper way, connect also with ourselves as well. So it's kind of twofold: self-worth, self-care, self-nurturing has this positive effect on money, but also where can you bring more nurturing connections to money also this week, which then helps you to receive more, it helps you to ask for more, it helps you to hold on to more of this thing, money, cash, credit, whatever it might be. So there's a lot of limiting beliefs around credit and having credit cards and debt. You know, there's a lot of shame attached to debt and a lot of guilt and all of that. Where can you start to release some of that and let go of those perhaps disappointments or regrets that we have that directly impact you then being able to have and receive more money? So as I say, there's so much. And if you want more support around money, then I would consider an Akashic Masterclass. I've got several on the topic of money, money connection, you actually connecting with the energy of money and what that feels like, looking at your money stories, releasing some of that in the Akashic records, the trauma, all of that. I've got a wealth of stuff that's available. So reach out again, let me know if that's something that you would like to explore. So Queen of Roses, all about your money and wealth. How can you nurture and nourish yourself this week that has that impact, that connection, but also how can you nurture and nourish money this week directly? So let me know how those cards resonate. And as I say, if you want to have a 2023 forecast with 12 cards, including your number one block that is going to support you when we clear it from the records, and also get your energetic coding, the mantra that I will create for you, then reach out. Those sessions are going to be £111. They're voice recording sent to you with the image of the cards. And that will include the healing within the voice recording, and also your mantra will be sent to you as well. So I've only got 11 of those, and they are 111. Reach out if you want to take to be part of that. Let me know. If not, have a great week and I'll see you in 7 days. Love and blessings. Have a beautiful one.